The existence of the submarine KRI Nangala 402 has been found. But until now it has not been able to be raised to the surface. Reportedly this 1977 German-made submarine is at a depth of 838 meters. In addition, the submarine was split into three parts, and the crew was thought to be difficult to rescue. Indonesian Navy Chief of Staff, Admiral Yudho Margono said, the submarine KRI Nangala 402, which was declared sunk on Saturday, April 24, 2021, was found to be split into three parts. There are parts of KRI Nangala, so their KRI Nangala is divided into three parts, said Yudho in a virtual press conference on Sunday, April 25, 2021. Yudho explained that the visual contact of the submarine KRI Nangala 402 was found at 9:04 Wito, carried out by the MV Swift rescue ship, after continuing the search carried out by KRI Rigel. Getting visual contact at position 074856, 07 degrees, 48 minutes, 56 seconds south and 114 degrees, 51 minutes, 20 seconds east, which is precisely from datum 1, the sinking place of KRI Nangala, approximately 1,500 to the south, at depth of 838 meters, he said. Yudho said, on the results of the visual contact, the KRI Nangala 402 submarine was split into three parts, such as the back of the ship, which is not a compressed body, the stern of the hull, and the detached bow. He said there were parts of the ship that were still intact but there were small cracks. This open part, Yudho showing the picture, is not very clear, because the underwater is not bright this morning, the parts of the ship inside. And this part is open and loose, he said. Furthermore, Yudho said, with the condition of the submarine, at a depth of 838 meters, it is very unlikely that 53 crew members will be saved. Earlier, the commander of the Indonesian National Armed Forces felt sorry for them. Of course, they were victims of this incident, he concluded. In the midst of this submarine incident, some of the public also questioned the fate of the 53 crew members. Why don't the crew go out and swim to save themselves from the sinking ship? It turns out that the reason is not simple. Apart from the complex submarine design, the water pressure on the deep ocean floor is the cause. So why don't the submarine crew get out of the emergency door and swim outside to save themselves? Reported by tribunge@m.com from compass.com, the first thing to know is that submarines do not have emergency doors that can be opened freely. Submarine doors are much more complicated than one might imagine, because they are designed to be inaccessible to seawater. To replace it, there is a rescue compartment where water cannot enter this part, because it has an isolation system even though other parts of the submarine have leaked. Reporting from the San Francisco Maritime National Park Association, it was in this compartment that the crew members escaped. Their chances of survival also depend on the depth of the water in which the submarines are located. What happens if the crew dares to leave the ship at 700 meters? If the crew opens the door to the submarine at that depth, the water will enter the ship very quickly and flood the ship in seconds. At low depths, the crew may still be able to withstand the pressure of the incoming water and try to swim out. However, at a depth of 700 meters, the water conditions are not like those felt in a swimming pool. Reporting from the Schmidt Ocean Institute, the hydrostatic pressure of water increases by 1 atmosphere every 10 meters. If the pressure in air is 1 atmosphere, then the pressure at a depth of 700 meters is 70 atmospheres. While humans can only withstand pressures of about 3 to 4 atmospheres. Swimming in seawater at a depth of 700 is impossible for humans, It might feel like being trampled by 100 elephants on the head. When the water enters the sub, in less than seconds the eardrum will burst, the lungs will be compressed causing excruciating pain and then burst, followed by blood vessels and organs throughout the body that are also destroyed. So opening the door of the submarine and swimming out is impossible unless the submarine is still at a shallow depth. As a reference, we can see the submarine rescue that has happened. For example, the Russian PRIS-AS-28 mini-submarine which sank in the Pacific Ocean on August 7, 2005, due to entanglement in cables. The Russian government, assisted by Britain, the United States and Japan, conducted a search for and evacuated the submarine. After the ship's position and the cause of it being trapped were found, rescuers began cutting the cable and tangling it. Reporting from the Maritime Journal, after the cable that entangled the PRIS-AS-28 was cut, the ballast tank was detonated so the ship could return to the surface. Reporting from the Maritime Journal, after the cable that entangled the PRIS-AS-28 was cut, the ballast tank was detonated so the ship could return to the surface. So that all the crew of the PRIS-AS-28 crew can survive after 3 more days trapped in the ship. From this, we can conclude that external rescue team assistance, is the best way to save the missing crew of the KRI Nangalang 402 ship. But time is the enemy in submarine rescue. The crew must be rescued immediately before oxygen supplies run out and before they catch the disease caused by inhaling carbon dioxide in the sinking ship. Meanwhile, the former commander of KRI Nangala 402, Lieutenant Colonel Lottasuri, said that the KRI Nangala submarine had the necessary safety equipment. Safety equipment has also been adjusted to the number of personnel on board the submarine. According to him, problems must have occurred in every ship and aircraft equipment. However, of course, personnel have also been trained to deal with potential problems that may occur. In addition, Indonesian National Army soldiers are also trained to survive in any condition.